Since its invention in 2012, CRISPR has been the one and only gene editing tool for treating people with genetic disorders. In late October 2019, Dr. David Liu at the Broad Institute of MIT and Harvard in Cambridge, Massachusetts, introduced a new technology called prime editing that in theory may correct 89% of the more than 75,000 disease-associated DNA variants listed in ClinVar, a public database developed by the U.S. National Institutes of Health. The technique uses methods similar to the earlier CRISPR technique, but with higher accuracy. However, according to the molecular biologist Eric Sontheimer at the University of Massachusetts Medical School in Worcester, prime editing may not be able to make the very big DNA insertions or deletions that CRISPR-Cas9 is capable of, so it's unlikely to completely replace the well-established editing tool. Different flavors of genome editing platforms are still going to be needed for different types of edits. So, what is the difference between CRISPR and prime editing? CRISPR-Cas9 and prime editing both work by cutting DNA at a specific point in the genome. CRISPR sometimes changes genes it shouldn't. With prime editing, researchers have far better control over the type of edit they want, because unlike CRISPR, with prime editing, scientists do not need to cut both DNA strands, and the technique doesn't immediately activate the cell's repair system that is prone to errors. CRISPR technology requires intervention for every specific type of DNA editing. Delete a gene, insert new DNA code, or DNA letter substitutions. Prime editing, on the other hand, can achieve all three functions without additional modification. Nevertheless, scientists warn that more research is needed before prime editing can be safely used in humans. Once ready, it has the power to repair harmful mutations known to damage the human genome that lead to conditions such as cystic fibrosis, sickle cell anemia, and a nerve-destroying illness called Tay-Sachs disease. Writing in the journal Nature, the scientists describe how they performed more than 175 edits in human cells, including targeted insertions, deletions, and all 12 types of point mutation with impressive precision. Fyodor Urunov, scientific director at the Innovative Genomics Institute in Berkeley, California, reviewed the paper for Nature and says, "Prime editing may become the way that disease-causing mutations are repaired, but," he adds, "it's too soon to be sure. The technique just showed up this year." One problem, however, is that prime editors are very big in molecular terms. They will not fit into the viruses researchers typically use for editing components into cells. Nonetheless, Dr. Liu is moving forward with plans to bring prime editing to patients. In September 2019, he co-founded a company called Prime Medicine that has licensed the technology from the Broad Institute to develop treatments for genetic disease. The Broad team will make the technology freely available to academic and nonprofit organizations. The researchers will continue to develop and test prime editing in the coming years. They need to figure out and experiment with new delivery mechanisms for the technology in animals. The ultimate goal is to achieve a viable human gene therapy. Did you like this video? Then show your support by liking, subscribing, and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.